Hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to see the science of air. Air is a mixture of gases, and all the gases have an important role to play. That means all the different gases that are present in the air, children, they all have a different function. They have a different role. They have a different importance. And what is the importance of all these gases? We are going to see them one by one. We start with the first one, that is uses of oxygen. Oxygen is required for combustion of fuels. Now, combustion, another word for combustion is also burning, children. So, oxygen is required for any kind of burning that is taking place in the environment. During this process, the oxygen of the air will react with carbon and hydrogen that is present in the fuel and will form carbon dioxide and water. Now, remember one thing over here, children. Whenever anything is burning in the presence of oxygen, it will always and always produce carbon dioxide and water as the end products. That means after the burning will take place, carbon dioxide and water will be formed. Oxygen being a supporter of combustion. Now, oxygen is such a gas, children, that it supports the burning. Without oxygen, nothing will burn. It brings about combustion of various fuels like wood, coal, LPG as well as CNG. Any kind of a fuel or any kind of a substance will burn in the presence of oxygen only. All these products liberate carbon dioxide on complete combustion and carbon monoxide on incomplete combustion. Now, carbon dioxide, children, you know the formula CO2. CO2 will be formed if a substance is burning completely. That means 100% combustion is taking place, carbon dioxide will be formed. If the substance is not able to burn completely, that is incomplete combustion, then another gas, which is carbon monoxide, will be formed. The formula is CO. Next is, oxygen is required for respiration of living organism. That means, children, for the respiration, we require the presence of oxygen. Breathing, that means taking in of the air and giving out of the air, taking in of oxygen, giving out of carbon dioxide is breathing, children. And respiration are two different phenomena. Now, respiration is how the oxygen that is inhaled in our body is taken in our body, how it is used for releasing energy from the food. That is respiration. Breathing, it is a process of inhaling, that is taking in, and exhaling, that is giving out of the air. Respiration, on the other hand, the process of absorption of oxygen into the blood for oxidation of food. Oxidation over here means combining with oxygen to release heat energy, carbon dioxide and water is known as respiration. Now, this is the definition of respiration, children. That how the oxygen that is taken in our body, what role does it play? It combines with the blood for the oxidation of food. Okay, and as a result of this oxidation, what is released? Heat energy, carbon dioxide, water is released. This is known as respiration. Next, we come to the comparison between breathing and respiration. How is breathing and respiration compared? Let's see that. Breathing is inhaling and exhaling only. That is taking in of the air and giving out of the air is breathing. Respiration, it is intake of the oxygen, and that oxygen will further help in the oxidation of food. Breathing is just a physical process, whereas respiration is a chemical process. Remember, in a chemical process, always a new substance is being formed. Next is, no heat energy is released during the process of breathing. Whereas, during respiration, always the release of heat energy is there. During breathing, no enzymes are required for breathing. And for respiration, is due to the particular enzymes that are produced in our body. So, this way we can compare and we can differentiate between breathing as well as respiration. Let us see, children, the comparison between combustion and respiration. Now, combustion is burning and respiration. So, how is burning and respiration related to each other, or what are the differences between them? Let's see that. Combustion takes place at a higher temperature outside the body. Now, whenever something is burning, like a fuel or a substance, it will take place outside the body at a very high temperature. On the other side, children, respiration will take place at the body temperature and inside our body. Respiration always takes place at the body temperature. Body temperature means the normal temperature of our body. Enzymes are not required for combustion. If we are burning something, we don't require any kind of an enzyme. You take a matchstick and you burn something with it, you don't require any enzymes. But during respiration, enzymes are required because this is taking place inside our body. So enzymes are required. Combustion takes place for various fuels. We can burn a various fuel for it. We can burn wood, we can burn coal, LPG, CNG, petrol, diesel. So a lot of fuels can be burned. Respiration takes place only for the food substances that are consumed by an organism. Respiration will only take place for only the food that we are eating. And not only us, but even the animals, the food that they are eating, respiration will take place only for that food substances. Combustion is a faster process. It takes place quickly, whereas respiration is a slow process. So these are the differences, children, between combustion and respiration, or you can say burning and respiration. Every day we are using oxygen or for burning, for respiration, and for the various other processes. But the amount of the oxygen in the air is not changing because of the process of photosynthesis. Now, what was photosynthesis, children? A process during which the green plants will make their food in the presence of sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide, and water, in which oxygen is released, and as a result, what is released? Oxygen is released. So plants, children, are continuously taking in carbon dioxide and they are giving us back oxygen, and we are taking this oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. So that is why the balance between the level of oxygen and carbon dioxide is being maintained. Next is photosynthesis. This is, we are seeing the importance of oxygen, the use of oxygen. This is the process during which green plants containing chlorophyll, with the help of carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight, will make their own food, that is glucose. And as a result of it, oxygen will be released. Now, this is known as a word reaction for the process of photosynthesis, where carbon dioxide is combining with water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to produce glucose, which we call it as the food, and will give out oxygen. Now, next, children, there's an activity given over here in your books to show that air is necessary for respiration. How can you prove that air is actually required for respiration? Now, they have taken two well-potted plants have been taken and they are covered by a bell jar. Now, bell jar is transparent, so you can see through it what is happening inside, and they are covered with a bell jar and they are left like this. You will see for few days the plants, no effect will be seen on the plants and they will be healthy. But after a few days, you will see that the plant will start shriveling down. It will start changing into a condition where the leaves can be seen wilting down. Now, why they are wilting down? Because in the beginning, a lot of oxygen was over here inside the bell jar, so the plant was able to do respiration. But when the level of oxygen finished after a few days, plant is not able to respire. Now, you must be wondering, do plants also respire? My answer is yes, plants also respire. The way we do respiration all 24 hours, the same way, children, the plants also do the respiration all the time. So this proves that air is necessary for respiration. Starting with the last part of the lesson, children, use of the other components of the air. What is the use of the other gases which are present in the air, such as carbon dioxide, children? Carbon dioxide is needed by the green plants to prepare the food by the process of photosynthesis. Right now we have seen that with the help of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide can be removed from the environment and oxygen can be given back. Next is nitrogen. The nitrogen which is present in the air is used to provide an inert atmosphere. Inert atmosphere means, children, you know, oxygen, there are two gases that are present in our environment. The maximum amount of the gas that is present is nitrogen, approximately 78%, and oxygen is only 21%. Now, because oxygen is a very good supporter of combustion, children, if we are not very careful and had nitrogen not been there, children, something which would catch fire will keep on burning only. So, when the oxygen of the air finishes, what comes next? Nitrogen. And nitrogen, because it does not support burning, so the things stop burning in the environment. It is also used for the protein manufacturing, synthesis means making, and for the growth of the plants. So the proteins are made in the presence or by the use of nitrogen. Next is inert gases like helium are used in the weather forecasting balloons. An ozone layer that is present in the atmosphere will help to check the harmful ultraviolet radiations from the sun to reach the earth. You know, children, the sunlight, along with the sunlight, even the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun, they come to the earth. And if a lot of ultraviolet rays will be allowed to come to the earth, then they, wherever they are going to fall, they will cause various kind of problems like diseases, various kind of problems, and even at times skin cancer can be caused if a person gets too much affected, say, by these ultraviolet radiations. So, who is stopping them from entering our earth? It is the ozone layer. Okay. So, with this we come to an end of this video. I hope you have understood everything. And if you really understood, you know what is to be done. Just please do subscribe, like and share my videos with your other friends. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead. Bye-bye. I hope, children, after seeing the entire video and after listening to me very carefully, you have understood each and everything that I have tried to explain you. Now, if you have really understood the lesson well, don't forget to please subscribe, like and do share my videos with many of your friends so that they also are being helped by me, that is Mrs. D. Nandan. So, thank you and have a wonderful day ahead. Bye-bye.